Hey guys. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Alyson, also known as Ally T Baby. I just moved to New York City. This is my apartment. And today's mission is to get, well really, not today's mission, but I'm on a mission to get 3 canvases to hang right over my bed. I'm gonna paint them myself and I'm going to show you guys how I do it because I need a buddy when I do stuff like this. Otherwise I will absolutely just fall through and not finish it. So I need you guys to keep me accountable to this. I'm very excited. I have like the layout and like my ideal all set. Today we're headed to Soho to go to Blick. And obviously also do some other shopping. But we're gonna go to Blick and get the canvases, and I already have my paints and like my supplies and stuff, so I should be pretty good there. Might need to pick up a couple different things depending on like the color scheme I end up going for, but we'll get there. I don't have a tape measure, so I'm gonna use this ruler to measure that space so that I can see like what size canvases I need to get. And my idea is that I'm gonna get 3 up and down canvases, so like vertical canvases, and then the design for it is actually super cute. This is stuff I've done before, so I actually created 2 of these back in like maybe February, or maybe like December, and they're on a smaller canvas, not nearly as big as what I'm about to do, but they came out really cute and I love them in my room and like I'm obsessed with them, so this is what I'm gonna do. I'm using these 2 designs because I think they're just so beautiful. Like, I can't think of better designs than these, except I'm going to change up the colors, and then it's going to be this one, and then in the middle there'll be a picture of a hand giving flowers, and it'll be like this beautiful brainy girl with all her flowers in her head has so many she's giving them away to this girl who just sits with her little flowers. It's so cute. That's what I'm gonna be putting up there. Color scheme still TBD. I'm thinking I wanna do it like this, kind of like this. Okay, I saw on Etsy something that called this desert rose, and that's what I'm gonna use to describe this color. Like a little desert rose color. Like, I think that could be really cute because this really is the theme of my room, is like this color and green, like these 2 together, and white. Like, this all together is like how my shit always looks. So I need to get something that'll match that vibe. So probably gonna pick up like some different strings for the stitching. That's probably gonna be another thing I get at Blick.
But for now, let's measure this baddie of a wall.
Cover with the paintings is 78 inches approximately, give or take. So I'm gonna go to Blick and just ask them. I'm gonna be like, hey, you know, I want to do 3 canvases, this is how much space it is, and like that's that. So that's what we're gonna do. So let's just like get to it, shall we?
Brushes because I'm gonna get a big canvas, so I feel like I need like a big brush for it, and this is like a cheap little thing, so love that. And then this is the tough part because I'm like, what size do I get? I don't know. The 24 by 30 seems sizable. Like, this seems sizable, but I also kind of want it to be longer. I should have measured up and down how high it was. Like, look at how much bigger that one is. I'm gonna go with the 24 by 36. It's pretty big, but I think it's perfect. And I like how these ones are thinner. Like, see how that one's like so fatty all the way back there?
Okay, so it's been a couple of days and I've been working on it a little bit. And I'm gonna give you guys obviously the step-by-step, but I wanted to kind of do one first to make sure I knew what I was doing because this is a bigger project than I've done before. But it came out really good, so I'll show you guys. But I did want to show you the next step that I'm doing, which is kind of like an in-between step, I guess, because I'm trying to figure out what I want the color scheme of all 3 of these to be. If you remember, the base is just like a little cream, like beige, brown, kind of pinkish a little. background, and then the stitching will add the color, but I do want to figure out the color scheme of how I'm gonna do this. My idea is to put up the posters, that way I can see what they look like and then kind of like color code them on my wall. So that I can then see like what color scheme I'm gonna do, because the whole thing is I'm gonna need to paint the canvas before I start with the stitching. So I wanna like get a little bit of a color scheme going. Obviously you guys know I have my different strings and stuff and I have a general idea, but just the actual like where shit's gonna go, need to figure that out. So let's figure it out. So I took out all of my string that I have, and then I kind of color coordinated each, like I have these markers for my bullet journaling, so I coordinated it each color, and then I'm gonna kind of like just color it in here to see what the vibes are.
I'm gonna start with the pink because I think it's easiest. I think I want her lips to be a lighter pink. I know I want these to also kind of be in that color scheme, or just like a light white color scheme. Also maybe this one. Okay, I think that's as abstract as I want to get there. And I might not keep her nails blue. I haven't decided. They may go back to like a nice like peachy color, kind of like her lip.
All right, so now. Oh, not good. Ew. I'm gonna restart a new one so you guys can see what it looks like from start to finish of how I do the whole thing. Now that I did that other one, it really like solidified what was up, which was good because I got nervous there for a second. But anyway, here we go. Okay, so as you guys know, I went and got these posters printed. They were like $16 from FedEx, but I just masking taped this down to the canvas, basically in the middle. And this is so it doesn't move while I'm poking, because if it did, then it would obviously not be aligned properly. Now let's get to pokey poke. I don't have a thimble for this needle, so I've been makeshift using this like command strip, just like pad as my thimble so I don't hurt my fingers. Here's how this works. Literally, I'm gonna take the painting and I'm genuinely just gonna poke through. It takes a while, but it's also pretty relaxing and fun, especially like the stitching of it is really relaxing and fun. But the poking's okay too. So one problem that I encountered that I hadn't had when I made these on smaller canvases was there's like parts of this that have this wood backing on it, and my smaller canvases didn't have that. So sometimes when I get to the area with the wood on it, like I can't poke all the way through. But basically all I do there is I just take, like I go in through the back and I just kind of push so there's like a little bit of space between the wood and the canvas, and it doesn't need that much space for it to poke through. You just have to like make the hole. Let's watch me poke this thing up. Okay, so it is hard to see because of the texture of this canvas, but like all those tiny dots that you see here and over here. Not me running out of tape in my final hour. All right, so this one's done too now, so I'm taping this off. And now they're all ready to be painted. All right, so I just mixed up some paints. Some of them didn't work out, which is fine. You live and you learn. But here we go. Okay, one, I almost just got paint all over my white bed, which would have been not good. But luckily this paintbrush had no paint on it. So when I swiped the bed, didn't get up. But anyway, come on, makeshift easel. Okay, so gonna take, like I said, the pink color. I'm gonna go in on the lips a little bit. I just wanna give that like a little like flare. Kind of nervous. I've never painted one of these before. So like, I don't know what's gonna happen. I might hate it, and I might redo it. Fixed it. I basically just want like the paint to accentuate the already there lines because I think it'll look cool. So let's hope that's the case. Okay, that's good for that. And then I need this for the fingernails for the other one. And for number three, I don't fully decide on the color scheme for three yet. Is like what I'm struggling with. I'm sure I make so much paint for this, considering I'm pretty much done with that, but okay. Okay, I'm gonna clean this brush, I think. Burb. Right now I'm remixing the like red color because I messed it up before. I feel like it's gonna be easier to see if I just do the red, the pink and the green first. So that's what I'm doing right now. We're getting somewhere. Okay, so I just finished the little, oh, a true artiste. I just finished the little painting moment and I'm doing less than I thought because I'm not loving how it's like looking right now. So bear with us here. And right now they look like literal blood splotches. I think it'll look better once it's like stitched. That's it right now. I'm almost done with that. I'm here on my bed as I usually am when I do this. Sometimes I sit in my living room and do it, but I like to do it in bed and watch TV. So all the materials I have here are my string, which I have a couple different colors, but we'll use the pink for now. I have this thimble that, aw, I bought this because it was a thimble for like long nails because I used to have my acrylics, but as you can see, I ripped them all off. So anyways, thimble. I have this tool, which helps you thread the needle. I know it's blurry, but it's basically just this like little thing that you put the needle through, and I'll show you this, but you put it through and it, like I said, helps you thread the needle. And then my needle is on my nightstand. Okay, so the first thing you'll do is take your string, and I do arm's length of string because if you go any longer, it's really easy for it to get tangled. And even though it's annoying to like restart new string constantly, it's also annoying when your string gets tangled and you're like wasting all of it because it's getting tangled up and you need to like cut it off or pull it out or whatever. It's just annoying. Little tip and trick. Okay, so then I take the end of it. Let me get like a nice close up here. So I take the end and I just tie a little knot. Whee! And I double knot this end and then I take it into, then I grab the other side. And this is the one, this is the side that will thread the needle through or with. This is my needle. This is my little helper, you can call it. And basically I take the end that I didn't tie and I put this and I just take my needle and just kind of line it up like that so that it goes through. And then when you take the end of your string, and I'd like to put it in my mouth just a little bit so that the, you know, this is cheap string. It comes unraveled pretty easily. So I like to make sure it's all still together. And then you just take this and poke it right through there. Like that, and then you take the needle off of this like helper and then it's through your needle. And this is a really helpful tool to have, honestly, because most needles have eyes, which is, you know, that part that the thread is through, much smaller eyes than this one. I specifically bought big eyed needles, I guess. So yeah, anyway, I would highly recommend if you do a project like this, getting a little tool like this. They usually come either with your items or in like a little pack, like right next to where you would find the needle. So, and then I just do one single knot around the top here and I try to push it as close to like the edge of the like little end hanging string there just to optimize how much string I'm getting out of my little thing. So here we go. We have one knot tied there and that knot will stay pretty well. Sometimes it'll come off, but you just put it back in and retie it. So now what we've got here is a string that's ready to be put in the canvas. Okay, so I just finished with all of that string. This is where we're at. Basically, I'll just tie a knot back here to make sure it doesn't like slip out or anything. And then I'll get started with the next string.
He's so handsome.
I'm about to stitch the last stitch of the last stitching. So I wanted to get it on video because this has been a real process getting these done. And Brody's here to celebrate with me. Hey, Brody. Brody's smelling my scissors. Good boy. He's so good. Okay, here it is. In one side, I'm pulling it through. And boom, just like that. 3 out of 3 are now complete. Time to hang them up. Yay! We're gonna hang them up now. Yay! Mwah! Yay! Say yay. Say yay, Brody. So shy today. Staring contest. Who's it gonna be? Brody lost. That's okay, we still love him. And now I'm just gonna tie the knot at the end. So I had a lot of extra string just because I wasn't sure how long it would take me, but I can cut most of this off. Get it there for safe measure. And then I'm gonna double knot this back here. And the back of these are not pretty. Like, they are full of mistakes, knots, and hanging string and all of that. But that's what makes the front of it look so beautiful. So like, this is what the back looks like. This one's honestly not that messy, but you know, there's the loose strings everywhere and stuff's popping out. But then on the front, we have the masterpiece. Yay! I am truly so proud of this accomplishment. Look at what I made for my bedroom. Like, what beauty. I love it so much. My bed's not made and Survivor's also playing in the background, but they're done and they're so pretty. All right, well, that's all I got for you. But if you have any questions, definitely ask them down below and try this and let me know if you do. It was honestly a long process, but a really fun process. So I hope you enjoyed and I'll see you next time.
Just want to say, Ally T, baby, subscribe, like, comment.